Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube, and at a train show, I bought this really old kit. It was an N-scale rolling bridge. It was pretty easy to put together. There's only a few parts. And this is what it looks like if you just put it together basically as is. I mean, everything was red? Really? I mean, the brickwork in some of these older kits is so nice, but you can't have things all red. And then the same thing with this plastic base. I mean, that doesn't look like the earth. And the bridge itself is nice, except for some of these older kits, sometimes the plastic warps. So I got to address that too. I handled the warping by just using the blow dryer, and I got it flat. And I used liquid nails to glue it onto this base. This base is only 8 inches by 12 inches. I had taken it outside and just used white primer. I use white primer for so much stuff before I paint. And I just basically primered the concrete post that hold the drawbridge up. So using liquid nails, you can do pretty much anything with liquid nails. I glued the plastic base to the pink foam. You can use anything. I'm not going to be cutting away at the foam. I just wanted a base to show you. You don't need a layout. You don't need a layout. We're going to make something really fun. I'm just using the 50 cent to a dollar acrylic paints. Nothing fancy, just beige. But now that gray plastic looks like old concrete. If you've watched my videos, I've done a million videos on painting. I used the cosmetic sponges, and I used that same beige color to lightly dab and paint the bricks. And then I used just a little bit darker of a brown because I'm making this all abandoned. There's going to be a story behind this. The story is a long time ago before the creek got rerouted, maybe the water was higher. Now they don't really use this drawbridge anymore. It's not going to be any real like boat traffic. So the place closed up, and I used just simple acrylics just to paint and weather this building. Nothing out of the ordinary than what I've done in my other videos. Just that was like a reddish orange, some gray. For the bridge, I'm just doing the same thing, just nicely, lightly dab with a mix of brown and rust and maybe a little bit of black. I'm not an artist. The bridge, I used gray primer, and then I rusted it all up with brown. And like a little bit of rust. You don't want shiny brown plastic. Kits are just supposed to be put together, but you have to paint them. You have to paint pretty much everything. Now, I've done a million videos where I use Sculpt-A-Mold. So this is nothing new. This is just basic Sculpt-A-Mold. I didn't even bother tinting it because I'm just going to paint the whole thing. Sculpt-A-Mold's so fun. This is fun. I'm telling you, you guys. People say, well, I've never worked on a layout. I've never done scenery, blah, 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 blah. come on, man. I mean, this was just like a two-day project. And I want you guys to get back into making scenery. And I made mistakes, and you'll see it in this video. I made mistakes, but it's just fun. You don't have to have this big basement empire. So look at this. 8-inch by 12-inch base, simple Sculpt-A-Mold, just kind of made an idea of where I think the ground would be and hills would be. My mistake is I wasn't really thinking about, the creek should have been flat. So that's going to be my big oops. But, you know, I don't care. Okay. So once the bridge was painted, now I used to suck at decals until I found out that Blair Line, these decals are the best I've ever used, period. End of story. They're already pre-cut. They come off the backing paper in about 45 seconds. And I just use that micro set and then micro sole. Nothing out of the ordinary, just like normal decals, but they're flawless. So, man, I'm going to go buy me some more. Unless Blair Line, you want to send me some? I just accented some of the bridge with yellow safety paint. Now, because that drawbridge piece is separate, I had to solder two wires to it. They give you the wires, and they give you a spot underneath the track to solder wires. So that was smart. Now, this is my own doing. I have this really, like, almost looks like 4x8 sheets of plywood, and I boarded up the door and the window, because, hey, they're not using the drawbridge anymore, so they're going to board up the building. Make your scenes tell a story. Pretty slick, huh? All right. Simple brown acrylic paint. And I just took I'm using cheap paintbrushes. I'm telling you, I'm using the 50-cent dollar store paintbrushes here. You don't have to make this big expensive purchase of like designer paintbrushes. No, just get the cheap stuff for scenery. And this is just brown paint. I just want to cover this whole thing. And you can use latex paint if you like. I was trying to get this done. I just wanted to get a video out to you guys. And I thought this would be fun. Here's green for the creek. I have no photos to reference. This is one of the rare times where I just decided to use my imagination. Say, okay, well, let's have the water come in this way. And let's have it do this. And I just kind of winged it. I used a little bit lighter color brown around where the water touches the sides. Yeah, in hindsight, maybe I should have made it look deeper. Okay, ballast, it's like a light brown and a dark brown and mixed together. I always mix my colors, always mix your colors. Look, I even have like dead grass. This makes sense, I'll tell you why. I used more dead grass than green grass. And I'm mixing it in with that like ballast, and you'll see why. If you want to use real dirt, I just didn't have time to go out and sift dirt and all that stuff. So that's why I used the ballast. But think about this. If it's going to be underneath the drawbridge, it's probably going to be more dead looking. So that's why I have it. I'm doing it over here underneath where the drawbridge would be. So I just use simple Elmer's glue, non-diluted. And then that little mix of dead grass and light grass and brown. This is only going to be underneath the drawbridge. But it looks so much better than if you just used one color, right? So I do both sides. And man, it really makes those concrete piers pop. Now here I'm going to do where the sun does shine. And the grass grew taller and more vibrant. And I used way more green than dead grass for this. So more Elmer's glue. And of course, I've sped up this video. Just, you don't want to watch an hour of me making scenery. So everything's like 2 to 3 times speed. Filming videos is not as easy as you think. If you don't believe me, try it. See how often your arm gets in the way too. It's not as easy as you think. My desk is against the wall, so I'm kind of limited on space. My favorite part is static grass whenever I'm not shocking myself, which happens often. I use the green and I think it's more of a dead grass type color. I don't know, but I even mix it up in here, making sure I don't shock myself. Once again, more white glue. For some reason, this white glue today just seemed a little watery, which actually is good. You want it more wet when you're using the static grass. I put my little pin in for grounding and the alligator clip. And here comes the static grass. Now, I know now it's hard to see that it's actually standing up on end. You'll see the final result when this is all done. It's pretty awesome. There is no, okay, make sure that you have like a good working area, because this stuff kind of does make a mess. It does. So don't do this on the kitchen table unless you have like a drop cloth down. And don't hit that static grass applicator against that nail or you'll hear the pop. Okay, let me show you how it's coming along. I waited till that paint was dry. I didn't want the static grass going into wet paint. All right, so we're going to do the other side now. When it's all dry, I just used a brush to kind of get it out of the creek. I also used duct tape. Duct tape's good instead of, because you don't want to use a shop vac because you might suck up too much. See, my mistake about not clearing out the plaster that was on the creek. But yeah, static grass, man, it's so neat. It's so fun. You don't have to use it everywhere. Let some ground show through. All right, coming back with the water. EnviroTech Light. Only difference between EnviroTech and EnviroTech Light, this has less calories. Okay, so it's a 50-50 mix. Don't you dare eat it. 50-50 mix of the epoxy and the resin. Sorry, I couldn't do a better job filming by myself. But anyway, I made like a dam. You see that white plastic? That was just glued there with like silicone. Okay. So I added a little bit of green acrylic paint, the same color that's on the base for the creek. That's just like two drops just to get, you don't want it too dark. You don't want it too dark. So just two drops if you decide to do it. And then I just used the popsicle stick. And it takes, I'm going to say, at least one day to dry. And it'll dry hard. Now, I wanted to get this video to you. So it is not fully dried yet. I think I'm going to do another video where I show you how to make trees and more vines and add some more character to the scene. But look at this. Dude, come on, man. If I can do this, you guys can do this. Stop giving me that excuse. You know how many times people say, I don't have a layout. I don't have room for a layout and blah, blah, stuff's in boxes and I haven't got around the scenery. I hear it all the time. And so I just showed you how easy this is. Now, come on, man, you guys got some good stuff, good engine and stuff. Make a little, for N-scale, 8-inch by 12-inch module, just like this, just so you can get back into the hobby and practice and make your mistakes, and so what? It's just a little thing. I don't care what scale you do. Just start making scenery. Try these painting techniques that I do in all my videos. Look at that, man. If I can do this, you guys can do this. And look how cool when the drawbridge is up. That's just a simple background. So I want to thank you for watching this video. More importantly, I got to thank people that helped me with the cost of making these videos because of the editing and all that stuff and the equipment. So I'm going to thank my Patreons in the month of August. Got some new super cool Patreons. So Bobby, Barry, and Joseph, I want to thank you guys so much for joining the Patreon. And also for people out there, the link to the Patreon is in this video's description. Also, you can follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram, all under DJSTRAINS, and my website, DJSTRAINS.com. And I'm going to do an OnlyFans. No, I'm not. Ew, that's so gross. I can't believe you thought I would do that. I do look good in a bathing suit, though. You're still watching? Bye.